I may see a silver deer. I may see a platinum deer. Therefore what? Nothing is superior to me. So you should not be overruled by whatever objects you see. Samahidaha. Have that stability, have that control, have that moderation, have that regulation, have that refinement. Main hoon aur mere charon aur duniya bhi hai. Donon ke beech kon shreshth hai? Kon uncha hai? बोलिए ना, कोई नहीं बोलता. सभी बोलिए ना इफ यू एग्री. कौन श्रेष्ठ है, कौन ऊंचा है? जो देखने वाला, जो देखा जा रहा है उससे ऊंचा है. सभी समय ऊंचा है. यू आर सुपीरियर एंड द वर्ल्ड इज इंफीरियर. इंफीरियर. आई एम हाई अप, हाई अप एंड द वर्ल्ड इज टू लो. दैट काइंड ऑफ ए फीलिंग यू शुड हैव. This is the great identity that a teacher can give you. What is that identity? You have got an anchor. Anchor. I am using the word I. It denotes not the perishable things like the body, mind, intelligence and the ego. It refers to something imperishable. Imperishable. It has not perished after my birth up to now. I continue to say I. So many times I have fallen sick. So many times I have been denied. So many times I have been affected, afflicted. In spite of it, the I remains in the sovereign place it is. And this is the greatness we have. Samahidassan behirantaramva. Behirantaramva. What you call bahya, that is outside. Bahya you call antara, inside. These are itself a division made by the mind. What? These are? So you have got an external world, sensory world of objects, shabda sparsha rasa rupa gandha. You have an internal world consisting of thoughts, emotions, feelings, doubt, fear, knowledge, forgetfulness and so many other things. Now both of these you must be able to have a control, a victory over. Samahidassan bahir antaramva. Kalam nayetaha sati karma bandhe. And then spend your time. You are born not because you wanted. And the body lives not because you want. The body lives because oxygen is available, the lungs are breathing, the heart is circulating, the food is, you have hunger, and you have taken food, the food is assimilated, the blood is generated, it is circulating. All the life promoting and life preserving conditions being around you, then alone your life prevails. So is it because you want or do not want? Or is it because it is the course of nature? It is because of nature that life goes on. Kalam nayethaha. So lead your life. How long? As long as the body will live. Maybe you have a heredity of 80, 90, 100 years. Then you will also live 75, 80, 85. Suppose you have a short living heredity, it is possible that you also die faster or sooner. But if you are careful, it need not be, because it is only with regard to the body. With regard to the mind, you must have an eternal life, everlasting life. Kalam nayethaha sati karma bandhe. Suppose you have some bondages, children are young, look after them, look after them. You are waiting for a pension. Okay, work for one more year. I have no objection. If you have some involvements, okay, respect these involvements, carry on. But, not as a slave of the world, but as a master in the world. Hoga kya?
Hoga.
See, as a master of the world, there is nothing to overpower us in this world because we are the consciousness. You may beat me, discharge a bullet at my heart and my body may perish, but I will not perish. I challenge you, please destroy me. Nobody can destroy. Vinasham avyayasyasya na kashchit kartum arhati. Destruction of this can never be done by anybody. And Shankara says, Ishwaraha abhi. Even God cannot destroy. God cannot?
Destroy.
God cannot destroy. Destroy. Impossible. See, this is the identity he can give you. When you get up from here, get up At birth, we are given two heredities. One is the mortal heredity by the body. Another is the immortal heredity by the power and presence that animate the body. As the body is there, so is the power that animates it. So the body gives you a mortal heredity, and the presence in the body gives you an immortal heredity. Please realize this second one and get up. I am immortal. I am immortal. I cannot be destroyed by anybody. See, even this feeling, this is what supported Arjuna. Otherwise, how could he have killed his grandfather and teacher? Situations drove himself to such a manner, in such a manner, that he had to kill them. So we evolved the dharma of the imperishable. Dharma of the imperishable. Hey, sunne ko acha hai kya? सुनने को अच्छा है, तब अनुभव करते समय कितना अच्छा होगा थोड़ा सोच लीजिए। इसके लिए कुछ कीजिए ना। सद्वासना स्फूर्ति विजृंभणे सदी ह्यसौ विलीनाप्यहमादिवासना अधिप्रकृष्टाप्यरुण प्रभायां विलीयते साधु यथा तमिश्रा ततस्तमः कार्यम् अनर्थजालम् न दृश्यते सत्युदिते दिनेशे तथा द्वयानन्द रसानुभूतौ न वास्ति बन्धो न च दुःखगन्धः न वास्ति बन्धो न च दुःखगन्धः दृश्यं प्रतीतम् प्रविलापयन् सन् सन्मात्रमानन्दघनम् विभावयन् समाहितः सन् बहिरन्तरं वा कालं नयेथा सति कर्मबन्धे। I am telling you something very, very important. This is the entire secret of spiritual wisdom, inner resources development. Don't think left and right. Be very focused. Drishyam pradidam pravilabayan san. Drishya means the visible. The visible is a word which stands by itself. Drishya means the visible. Whatever is perceptible, perceivable, is being perceived. That is called drishya. When we were born into this world, we were born with a body. And what is this body? This body is actually an arrangement. What is a tree? The tree primarily rests upon the roots. The roots are invisible. The trunk is very much visible. The trunk itself is one from where branches shoot off. And from branches you have bi-branches and so many twigs, buds, flowers, fruits and the like. Our body is also supposed to host, it is only meant to host the senses. Am I clear or not? And these senses, our own body, the power within the body has made these senses. It is not anybody else's creation. It is the creation of the power and the presence that are within the body, which animate the body and activate the body. Very clear? And when we are born, the body through the senses starts interacting with the objects of the world. This is the primary stock of our life. Every sensory organ interacts with its object. The interaction, it is not completely by the senses. The senses are activated by the mind, employed by the mind. And after the interactions, the interactional impacts and outcome fall in the mind. Now you tell me, are the senses supreme? Or the presence inside the body, which has made the senses, which animates and activates and employs the senses, which is supreme? This you understand very clearly. For the making of the senses, our body and our mind have not depended upon any second factor. This much is clear. Now, do you have an intelligence or at least a heart to appreciate what the wonderful power within the body does? Can you trace a power or presence anywhere in the world different from and superior to this inner presence? Because it has made the senses, it has made the body. And through the senses, it interacts with the objects. And the world is what the senses find and report. If we have no eyes, there will be no objects in this world at all, visible. If you have no ears, there will be no sound. Don't think that the sound is first and the senses are next. I would like you to say that senses are the first and then alone. Shabda, Sparsha, Rasa, Rupa, Gandha. These are later. Am I right or not? If you have any difficulty in understanding, let me know. I will not get up from here, today is Sunday, without making you understand. ए दुनिया हमारे लिए कुछ नहीं करती है. हम तो स्वयं बोलते हैं हमारे चारों ओर दुनिया चमक रही है. This is our verdict. That the sun is rising, it is not the verdict of the sun. It is the verdict of our eyes. And who has made the eyes? None of the objects in this world. So, the power and presence within the body are actually supreme. Because they have made the body, they have made the senses, and through the senses alone, objects are perceived and interacted with. So, the interaction proceeds from the mind, and senses come in between. And when the senses come, suddenly the objects also appear. Our senses and the mind can remain without the objects. But the objects cannot remain without the subject. This is a conclusion that you have to arrive at. Why I am saying so much? Because drishyam pradidam pravilabayan san. The entire drishya, the visible, you have to dissolve in your own mind. What did I say? The entire visibles, drishya, will have to be dissolved in the mind. Now, Swamiji, how is it possible? The objects are gross. They are huge. And so many are there. How can I dissolve them in my mind? Yes, you can. You should. Is there any object, say, here is an object. Does this object in any manner affect me or influence me, except when my mind forms an imprint of the object in itself? ये कितने बार हम कहें, थोड़ा सोच लीजिए ना. No object becomes an object, for my experience, except when the mind forms an imprint of the object in itself, in the mind itself. And what is the imprint the mind makes in itself? Is it objective or subjective? थोड़ा बोलिए ना, एक हजार बार बोलिए. एक बार बोलने से काम नहीं चलेगा, एक हजार बार बोलना चाहिए. Even when you fondle your child, that fondling is a physical act. But the physical act is experienced by the mind within. When the mind forms an imprint of the fondling in the mind itself. Suppose you are sleeping and your child is rolling on your body, will you experience it? क्यों? बोलिए ना. The child is fondling physically on your body, rolling on your body. But you are not able to feel it because you are sleeping. So, actually, are objects giving any experience or the subject imprints of the objects alone give us experience?
Subject.
This assembly will have to decide on it. Boli. I am seeing the sun. The sun is at a distance. I am here somewhere on the corner of the globe. And when the sun rises, I see it. Have I gone to him? Has the sun come to me? I am standing where I am, but I am seeing. What sun am I seeing? Am I seeing the sun at a distance? Or am I seeing the sun reflected and projected by my mind within the body? This you have to tell me very clearly. I never have any access to the sun. I only have access and experience of the sun, which is reflected, imprinted in the mind by itself. So, have I at any time experienced any object as a physical entity, or I only experience the imprints of the objects, physical objects in my mind? The imprints in the mind, are they physical?
No.
Are they gross?
No.
Can I trust you?
No.
Can I trust you?
Yes.
So whether it is your son, your married partner, your father, your mother, your sofa, the entire Panchabhautik world around, all of them are experienced only as subtle inner imprints generated by the mind in itself. Am I clear or not?
Yes.
When the mind creates an imprint of the object in itself, whose product is that imprint? The mind's product. I don't know what the sun is. I only know what my mind forms in the form of an imprint of the sun. So I am seeing only the imprint sun, not the object sun. The object itself is a sensation, it's a cognition by my mind in itself. Itna to theek hai? The entire world experienced by you, in whichever manner it is, all these experiences are subjective. They are mind-born, mind-subsisting, subsisting on the mind, and mind-dissolving. Boli achi tarah. So we don't have anything other than the mind's imprints. The imprints are not formed by the sun. The imprint is formed by the mind. Where? In itself. And in the process the mind has employed the senses. And these senses are made by the mind. So what is there non-mental in the whole process? Thoda boli hai na soch ke. What is there non-mental in the whole process? Our body is evolved. What is by the mind? I mean the consciousness. I make it simple by saying it is the mind. So the mind itself independently has formed the entire body. Cell after cell was collected. And here it became the eye. Here it became the nose. Here it became the tongue. Here it became the ear. All these things, then inside skull, everything is made by the mind, taking the blood cells from the mother. That's all what it has taken in the form of food. Now, with those senses which the mind has independently made, employing those very senses, it says there is a world outside. And here is that world, experience it. It takes an imprint and gives you the imprint for experiencing. So, at any time, please tell me, is there any experience arising in man other than inner experiences, other than subject experiences, caused and made and preserved by the subject mind, which is not matter, not energy? So, if this is the truth, can I not dissolve? The mind that is reflecting the world, the mind should dissolve the imprints that it has taken. So dissolve your mind's imprint of the world in itself, finding that mind is the source, mind is the genesis, mind is the cause. So many thoughts arise in your mind. So many thoughts arise in your mind. They are arising from the mind. They are subsisting in the mind and they are getting dissolved into the mind. So the mind is already dissolving all the thoughts, all the emotions. Everything is dissolved in the mind. Everything arises from the mind. Everything is subsisting on the mind. Does the mind have the power to dissolve? You answer me.
Yes.
And the mind has to dissolve not physical products. I don't have to dissolve the sun that is arising there. I don't know anything about him. I only know the sun reflected by my mind. Because it is arising from the mind, originating from the mind, it can also dissolve it. So the entire drishya can be dissolved in your mind. When I see all of you, when I see all of you, I am not seeing any one of you. I am only seeing the imprint made by my consciousness in itself about you. So is there any experience in this world which is called objective in character? Somebody was asking me, our Indira Vijay Kumar, Swamiji, when you are finding some article, you can hold it like that. Is it not something gross and physical? I said, this is a touch sensation. This is a? Suppose your sensation has become very weak. You know, one splinter had entered into my finger. In Jamshedpur, they took me and the superintendent, the highest officer there, he came and he said, there is a foreign matter there. We will take it. So he gave me an injection. The whole fingertip desensitized. And then he was pricking and taking, but I never knew anything called pain. Even touch can be taken away. Pain is one, touch is another. So even suppose your hands are not sensitive, you hold an article, will you ever know it? Close your eyes and hold. You will never know that there is an article here. In fact, not only touch, every sensory organ, the experience is arising from contact. When do you see an object? Light rays falling on the object get reflected, they pass through the air. They touch the cornea, then only you have experience. Similarly, an article placed on the tongue, 1 millimeter away from the tongue, will you feel the taste? Similarly, smell. Everything is touch, everything is contact. It is a delusion to think only in the matter of the skin the touch is there. Everywhere it is contact. Without contact, the senses cannot experience anything. Now, all these contacts are felt by the mind. So you tell me now, you may take your own time, but you should tell me, is there anything called the object world except the mind making you feel that it is objective?
Yes.
So the very subjectivity and objectivity, both are divisions made by the mind. And this mind, you clearly say that it is not external, it is inside the body. Not only that, it is not physical, it is not material, it is not energetic. Then where is the trouble now? Drishyam pradidam. This drishya, this visible, is actually pradida. It is an awareness, it is a cognition produced by your mind. Apart from a cognitional world, there is no way of proving there is an object or a physical world. There is a cognitional world. Our mind cognizes, and in that cognition it makes a division called subjective and objective. So the very subject-object distinction is actually made by the mind. San behirantaramva. Behirantaramva. There are two kinds of objects. This also you should understand. One is called the gross object. Another is called the subtle object. What are the gross objects? Whatever is away from the senses. And what is the subtle object? Thought, emotion, doubt, understanding, sleep, dream. All these are subtle. What is the meaning of the word subtle? That which is present inside the gross is called subtle. And that which hosts the subtle is called the gross. So the grossness and subtlety are also mind-bound, and there are two kinds of objects. If the mind can dissolve thoughts and emotions, it can also equally dissolve the world impressions also. Am I clear or not? Thoda kijiye na. Never say that anything in this world is greater than I am. Don't live here as a slave in this world. Live here as a master in this world.